Hey, what's up guys, it's Kaustubh here and today we will be taking a look at the DIRF Fetch custom ROM for the OnePlus 3T, and this is an Android 10 based custom ROM. So as per the drill guys, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming content. With that being said, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So firstly guys, we will take a look at the about info of this DIRF Fetch Android 10 based custom ROM. So here in the about phone, I will go into the Android version. Firstly, we get this cool DIRF Fetch logo, which looks really cool. Android version is Android 10. Obviously, this is Android 10 based custom ROM. Security patch level is the latest August 5, 2020 that we get here. DIRF Fetch version is 10. Basically, this is the latest build, August 10th August 2020. This is the latest build available for the OnePlus 3T. Then a kernel version is given as well as the kernel name. So Panther kernel, it is a custom kernel which has been used with this specific custom ROM. So the main speciality of this ROM is guys that it is a AOSIP based custom ROM. Yes, AOSIP is sort of similar to AOSP, and that's the main speciality. Like AOSIP is basically a tweaked version of the stock AOSP custom ROM. So that's about for the about info. Second thing is the display and the ROM customization guys. So the display customizations, in the display option we can see all of them are pretty basic. All of them are pretty self-explanatory, sort of same that we get to see in all other Android 10 based custom ROMs overall. So game drawer preference have been given here, so you can select that. So that is one new thing that I saw in the display itself options. Then other than that, everything is pretty explanatory. Dark theme has been given to you. You can select the primary color, you can schedule the dark theme as well. So this is for the display customization. And talking about the ROM, then we get a separate tab called as the DIRF Quest. So it feels pretty fancy, but then too we got all this customization: theming, status bar, quick settings, button, gestures, lock screen, power menu, notifications, animation, miscellaneous and about. So that's about for the display and ROM customizations. Third thing guys is the overall usability and performance of this ROM. Then by default we get this lawn chair launcher, and this is the similar launcher that we get to see on a lot of Android 10 custom ROMs. I have shown you a lot of times on each and every ROM. So we get all the customization features in here. You can customize it according to your personal taste. Then the launcher is also pretty sleek to use. I have been using it for about now 2 to 3 days around, and it has been pretty good to me. There were no any random freeze or crash which I had observed in my testing period. And also talking about performance, so I have done this benchmark test. So we'll just take a look at the scores as well. So the benchmark scores are about 185,990 guys, and this is not the highest score which I had previously in my older ROMs, but this score is also okay. I was expecting a lot because it is a AOSP based custom ROM at the end, but then too it is a pretty decent score. You can judge how the overall performance of the ROM will be from this Antutu score. Talking about the network guys, then VoLTE services are working. I have got the Airtel India SIM card here, and you can see the VoLTE icon on top. So I'll just quickly show you in network, in mobile network. Then as you guys can see, I have got Volt services as enabled, so VoLTE services are working absolutely fine. No issues whatsoever with Volt at least. Then talking about security features guys, then this ROM just doesn't have any face unlock, so you have to unlock it with your fingerprint always. I'll just show you in security here. As you guys can see, we don't have any face unlock option. I hope this will get updated soon and face unlock will come. Talking about the camera performance of this ROM guys, then I was pretty impressed to see Gcam version 7.3 has been pre-installed. We don't get any AOSP camera, so that is really kind of the developer to include this option by default, so we don't have to install any APK. So I will just quickly show you the info. So we get Gcam 7.3, and guys, all of you guys know that Gcam is just absolutely awesome. You get really good high quality pictures from this Gcam app. So already I have made a review about the Gcam 7.3. You can check it out right here. So lastly guys, talking about is the battery life of this custom ROM. Then I was getting around 4.5 to 4 hours of screen on time, as you guys can see in the screenshot. Some days I used to get 5 hours, but it was only some days. So battery wise this ROM is decent. I would not say that it is bad. It is performing equivalent to any other Android 10 custom ROM here. And also talking about the battery menu guys, then it is a pretty basic one. We get battery saver, then we get adaptive battery, and that's about it pretty much that we get in the battery menu. So overall, talking about this Durfresh custom ROM guys, then what I think about is that it is a good ROM. I should say it is not bad by any means. It is absolutely stable, has Volt, but only downside I thought is with face unlock. So face unlock is what I look for in each and every custom ROM, but this ROM doesn't have it. Hopefully they include it in the future builds of this ROM. So overall this is a good ROM, and if you want it you can try it out as well. And talking about the best ROM, as you guys keep on asking me every time in all of my videos, the best custom ROMs are the two which I always suggest. First one is Android Pie based, so it is the Skydragon OS, which I have made a video of already, you can check it out right here. And the second one is the Android 10 ROM, which is Evolution X 4.4. So though also of that I have made a video right here, you can check it out as well. So those are my two ROM recommendations, and that's about it for this quick, short and simple Durfresh custom ROM review for you guys. So I hope you guys have liked this video, and if you like it then please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2e signing off. You guys have a great day.